Namo Adida Fa, good morning. It's Monday, May 11th, 2020, and we're here for our daily practice check-in. Listen, listen, listen. This beautiful sound calls us back to our true home. The first wonderful precept, aware of the suffering caused by the destruction of life, I vow to cultivate compassion and learn ways to protect the lives of people, animals, plants, and minerals. I am determined not to kill, not to let others kill, and not to condone any act of killing in the world, in my thinking, or in my way of life. We're continuing to read Ajahn Suchitta's book, Kama and the End of Kama. Today we're reading a section on the Great Heart. In the course of working on karmic patterning, we need to develop the measureless intent, as well as other strengths, to help us both with involuntary tendencies and with self-view, the way we habitually regard ourselves. This means developing great heart and deep insight. The two developments are based on awareness of patterning. This is what occurs through meditation. You may acknowledge a negative pattern such as residual tension, irritability, a sense of inadequacy, or heaviness in the heart. Negative moods may arise, the mind may feel cramped and jaded, and memories, mood tones, and flashbacks may rise up with poignant intensity. That gives us an unpleasant weight, a sense of being someone who is carrying years of history and accumulated habits. The pattern feels like a huge lot of baggage. How to put it down? How much more is there? Also, if we've picked up some baggage just through being alive, the likelihood is that we'll go on picking up more. So how to drop the weight and stickiness of being alive? Well, if I'm averse to it, that aversion merely adds to the weight. If I sustain the view that the way I am is because of what others have or haven't done to me and resign myself to that, that resignation locks rather than releases the old patterns. Telling myself to snap out of it doesn't clear anything. If I ignore the nature of my patterning by absorbing into sights and sounds, tastes and ideas in the present, then I may be unaware of it for a while, but when the music stops, it's back to me again, with my mood swings and jaded self-image. Meanwhile, the actions that I've undertaken to get away from myself, and the act of negligence and distraction, all that karma has its effects. Dropping this weight comes around through meeting patterns with great heart, which entails cultivating a strong current of intent. We do this by cultivating the three streams of patterning: body, heart-mind, and thought-speech. So we leave the negative track and establish a track based on clarity and goodness. When you do this in meditation, mindfulness of breathing can spread and refine any positive effect through the entire nervous system. Then mindfulness of breathing can spread and refine that positive effect through the entire nervous system. When the mind spins out, you can direct it back through a simple thought asking, "Where am I now?" Or, "Where is my breathing in this?" Then the energetic form of the negative pattern, its hindering tightness or push, gradually dissolves into the stream of steady presence. This is how samadhi, concentration, gets developed. It embeds the emotive, impulsive base of the mind in deeper currents than that of sense contact and discursive thought, so that a sense of firm ease acts as a keel to check memories and moods from overwhelming the mind. This process makes the mind great in terms of its energetic boundaries and capacity. You have some gravity that isn't just internal tension. In tandem with this, you develop great heart through attending to the heart with measureless intent. From this angle, if sorrow or agitation or fear well up, rather than reenact old habits of feeling bereft, trying to figure out a solution or analyzing the problem, you ask, "How am I with this now?" The aim is not to shift away from the topic, but to a non-involved view of the topic, to allow mindful awareness to get underneath the story to the emotion. There may be a numb, tense, or agitated emotional state, along with tension in the chest or palpitations in the heart. Don't go into that. Instead, find a place in your body where you sense ease or steadiness, and spread awareness from that place to the edges of the difficult area. Be at a place where your heart sense can be onlooking and compassionate, being with but not in the feeling. If you sustain that empathy and steadiness, the great heart develops. It has a positive current which can straighten, uplift, and refresh the body and mind, and you just sit in that and bathe the afflicted places until the system comes into balance and feels fresh. This is basic sanity. If you go into a world of random cause and effect, when you're ill at ease, tense, or depressed, you're leaving yourself wide open to laying down some unskillful karma. But with the great heart, we don't get knocked about, defensive, or reactive. May all beings be well. May all beings be happy. May all beings be peaceful. Sadhu. 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 Thank you for beginning this week with me, and we'll be back again tomorrow.